Your favorite ride at Islands of Adventure, was it Hagrid's or the little knee scooter that you rode on the whole week?
So that knee scooter was amazing and was handy to have given my situation. I broke my heel right before the trip, but Hagrid's is definitely one of my top rides of all time, not just at Universal.
But you had a Universal Unlimited Express pass for your scooter, right?
I did, yes.
You ride that all the time, okay.
Yes.
Don't stop believing. Hold on to that feeling. Streetlight.
Hey everybody, welcome to another video series where today we're asking you to be a believer. And we have a special guest as we continue our video series. We had Kyle and Amanda before. You're getting the boss lady today. This is Miss Mary Morning Radcliffe, an awesome lady. I have known her for many, many years outside of Believe Vacations and now as an agent. And today she's going to help me talk a little bit about our third and final resort category, which is deluxe resorts. Now we're going to be getting into all kinds of topics about what you can expect at a deluxe resort. But I do want to give you an opportunity to meet the boss, meet Mary Morning, and learn a little bit about her. Mary Morning, what got you into this? What made you start Believe Vacations? And tell us a little bit about just your Disney history before we get rolling into this.
Yeah, so I will say this week I had somebody just tell me I was born for this because my passion is Disney. Everything in my life is centered around Disney, but specifically with travel, I grew up in Alabama, went to high school with Brian, good times, but my family would travel to Disney World at least once a year as I was growing up, sometimes multiple times a year, and as I got older, the trips just became more and more frequent. My Disney obsession just grew stronger. And I started having friends asking me for advice. And because I've been to the parks so many times, I've stayed at almost all of the Disney hotels. So I could just easily tell people these are the fast passes that you need when fast passes were around. These are the top dining reservations based on your budget. This is the hotel that I think you should stay in. And so it just kind of spiraled from there. I decided to start Believe Vacations almost 5 years ago, and
crazy.
Here we are.
Yeah, 5 years ago. I think I came on year four or something of that nature. So it's been a wonderful journey. And Mary Morning is not an owner where she puts it all on the agents. No, she's still booking her own vacations. She's still working with her families. And so we've given the contact information for Mary Morning at the bottom of this. So feel free to reach out to her with any questions. And of course, if she needs to put you in touch with one of her agents, she will. And I guess with her backstory, you know, you think about the time when Mary Morning and her family were going to Disney, there weren't a lot of resort properties at that time, maybe a few dozen, maybe a half dozen at the most. And a lot of those were the deluxe resorts around the monorail loop. So that's where Mary Morning has her expertise in the deluxe resorts. Now, as we get into this, you'll probably go and you'll search, okay, what is a deluxe resort? We'll go ahead and be honest, because that's what we want to do here with Believe. These rooms are going to be around $450, anywhere upwards of $750 for a standard room. So we will go ahead and address that. They're not going to be on the cheaper end, but we'll get into why we think they are still a wonderful value here as we get talking. And what we're going to talk about mostly today are the standard rooms. Standard rooms are usually defined as two beds, the bathroom, and in some cases, just a little bit of living area. We'll talk about that. So mostly for that, we're going to focus on the four resorts that are open right now at the time of this airing, four standard rooms, which are the three on the monorail loop. That's the Grand Floridian, that's the Contemporary, and the Polynesian. And also where we stayed as agents a few weeks ago, right behind me at the Yacht Club. Now, first, I've showed you the Yacht Club. Mary Morning, where are you? Because that is gorgeous.
I am at the Grand Floridian.
Ah,
the beautiful Grand Floridian lobby that greets guests as they walk in. It's stunning in person.
So instantly, you're looking at the picture of me at Yacht Club and you at the Grand Floridian. And if you're a family of four or five, you're probably immediately going, my kids will not like that. And so let's just jump right into this and say, Mary Morning, will kids and families with kids enjoy these types of resorts, even though it may not be Disney all in your face, will they enjoy this? What are your thoughts? Because you've brought your kids many times to deluxe resorts. Yes. What do they think?
So, as you mentioned, I grew up staying at the deluxe resorts because when I was younger in the 80s and 90s, that's what was around. Mm-hmm. And so they hold a special place in my heart because a lot of Disney for me is nostalgia, trying to bring back those old memories. Mm-hmm. So I get fulfillment from staying at the deluxe hotels. So one thing that you will love about the deluxe hotels and what kids will love, especially of the monorail hotels, as you mentioned, those are next to the Magic Kingdom, Grand Floridian, Contemporary, and the Polynesian. And what I tell my clients that have young kids is you're going to feel like you're still part of the magic because you will walk outside of the building and you will be able to see Cinderella Castle right there. Or you can even choose a room that has a theme park view. So, and when fireworks are going on, what better place to stay? You can sit in your room at night, get on your balcony, watch the fireworks from your room, or wake up and see Cinderella Castle right there. So that is so magical to me. But then aside from that, even the deluxe resorts that aren't next to the Magic Kingdom, there's so many amenities and recreational activities that are great for kids. They have really great pools. They have big slides. There's always pool activities going on, which they have those at the other hotels also. Some of them have kids clubs, and I'm referencing pre-COVID times because this is definitely a unique time right now. But there's so many activities. And yeah, my kids have been to a variety of hotels. They've stayed at the Value, Moderate, and Deluxe hotels, and they enjoy exploring the hotels as well. And a lot of these deluxe hotels will have character dining as well. So that's extremely convenient for if you're wanting to do an early morning breakfast, you can just go right down to the lobby and eat a character meal there.
No, and you've mentioned so many things at once. It's hard to unpackage everything you just said. I mean, we can cut the interview now, but you know, let's go back and rewind a little bit, the convenience. Yeah. You know, when we stayed at Yacht Club, along with Beach Club and Boardwalk, when they opened up and they expand back into it, is right in the middle of two parks. And that's right. Hollywood Studios and Epcot. And on those days where we as the agents walked, I think it was an 8-minute walk to the International Gateway of Epcot. And it was a 10-minute walk to Hollywood Studios. And then at the end of the trip, my wife, Matea, and I, we went ahead and stayed a night at the Contemporary, which I know is your favorite. And we'll talk about that here in a little bit, too. But the Contemporary, it was so nice. And I could just picture a family who had a little child in a stroller. And it's been a long day at the park. And everybody's tired. Everybody's sweaty. Everybody's cranky. And now you got to get in line for a bus to go back to your home. No. You walk out of the park, you walk to your room, probably 8-10 minutes, and you are home. So the convenience and the location of these, definitely you are getting your price and admissions worth right there. But then you mentioned also the food options. Now, when we were talking about value resorts, we're pretty much going to stop at the food court areas. And for some families, that's all they need, and it's fine. For moderates, we started to get into there's food court plus a little bit of signature-ish dining specific to that resort. So whether it was Caribbean, the Caribbean flavor, or whether it's Coronado and kind of that Southwest Mexican feel. But now we're getting into locations where you can do character meals pre-COVID times and not have to spend price admission. So expand a little bit, if you will, just about the food option, because food's a big part of when you take a family to Disney, and deluxe resorts have wonderful options.
Yeah. So what's great about the deluxe resorts is you do have a lot of food options. So like you mentioned, you're always going to have that quick service option. And that's really important to me, just having a variety of food, because when my family goes, we'll go sometimes for a week to 10 days. So by the end of the trip, my kids are tired. And at the end of the day, they want to just go back to the hotel and eat. And so it's nice to have those food options, so you're not just going to the same food court every day.
Yeah.
So if you want, you'll have the quick service, and then you'll have multiple table service options. So there will be a signature restaurant at those hotels, but there'll also be more of a casual dining place that appeals to all families. And so I think it's nice that you're able to have those options if you want to. So on our last trip, we did stay at the Contemporary, and on our last night, because of the new walk-up availability that they have, we were able to get a walk-up to California Grill.
Nice.
So we just had to wait about 30 minutes, and we just went right up to the California Grill and had dinner because we were tired of eating at the Contempo Cafe. So it's definitely nice. And then aside from that, they all have lounges. So that's something that appeals to my husband. He is a much more laid back traveler. So he loves that lounge atmosphere, just being able to go somewhere and relax, maybe have an adult beverage, and then you can order some appetizers for your meal.
Yeah. And I love how you're transitioning there and talking about now a different type of vacationer, which may be a couple looking for a romantic weekend or getaway. You don't always have to bring the kids. That's going to sound counterintuitive. You know, you're not bringing your family to Disney. What is wrong with you? Well, there's nothing wrong. In fact, it could be wonderful vacation and getaway. If you look at it, I mean, here you are at the yacht club that I have behind me. I mean, this is basically going to some almost like marina in, you know, the northeastern United States. Or if you go to the Polynesian, that's going to Hawaii without getting on, you know, going across in a few hour time zones and stuff, and that kind of South Pacific feel. So you really are feeling like you're transporting yourself to other getaways that you would normally do, but you're just going to Orlando, Florida. So the theming of it for a couple in Merry Morning is, I think it's one of the more romantic aspects of Disney are these deluxe resorts. And would you agree we would highly encourage this for an anniversary or a getaway for a couple?
Definitely. Yeah. And as you mentioned, they each have a unique theme. So you can choose a theme that appeals to you. So I feel like the Yacht Club, all those hotels around the Epcot area and Crescent Lake are very romantic. Just being able to stroll along the boardwalk at night. It's right. Very romantic feel. Also, the Grand Floridian, you can't pass that up. The ultimate luxury hotel in Disney World. but what's also appealing is that these deluxe hotels are a little more laid back. You just have a more laid back vibe. It's quieter. I love going back to the hotel in the middle of the day, and we'll touch on this, but it just has that more like a calm feeling when you're at these deluxe hotels because you don't have as many kids just running around. You have a little bit more of a seasoned traveler, I feel, comes to the deluxe hotels, or those that are more accustomed to staying at nicer places. So it's not as crazy and hectic, and they'll usually have very calming music that's playing. So
nice.
It's great for couples, just if you want to go somewhere and relax, go to the lounge and have a drink, or just go lounge by the water.
Well, you know, as agents, we always encourage our families, especially those with either young kids or those who, like you say, you know, you go for 7-10 days. I mean, that literally is becoming home. And we don't always encourage just go, go, go in the parks. Now, if you're down there to enjoy the attractions and all that, then yes, by all means, we will set you up with tickets from the moment you get down there to the moment you leave. But sometimes we like to build in one day of rest, or we'll, in a case of a long stay like yours, we may even build in 2 days of rest. So if you are staying at a deluxe resort, Merry Morning, what are some of the things, the ways that, like you said, you unwind? I know you said we'll get back to this, so let's just go ahead and cover it now. What are those features at some of these resorts, maybe some specifics or just in generalizations that you say, when you take your day off from the parks, here's why you really don't have to leave the resorts, or just hit the ones that are kind of in the, like you mentioned, in Grand Floridian, hit the monorail loop and see the other ones on that. Or here at Yacht Club, walk around Crescent Lake and see the beach club, the yacht club, and also boardwalk. But just tell us a little bit about what you do on your downtime at a deluxe resort.
Yeah, so this kind of goes back to when I was little. My family, we were the type of family that would go back to the hotel in the middle of the day. It was usually summertime, so that's the heat of the day. Great time to go back to your hotel. Some families will go back and swim, but I have four older brothers. And so what was appealing to us was the arcade.
Yes.
And so we loved the Contemporary arcade compared to the other monorail hotels because it was the biggest.
Yeah.
So that's kind of why we always stayed at the Contemporary. So you're going to have that arcade, but all the hotels have the arcade. But like you said, the deluxe hotels do have that higher price point. And part of that is because they have more activities. So definitely take advantage of the hotel because you're paying for it. So you might as well enjoy it. So going back to the pools, the deluxe hotels have cabana rentals. So if you just want to spend a day at the pool, you can do that and have a nice home base to relax where you're not having to sit out in the sun all day. Or some of the hotels like Contemporary and the Yacht Club offer boat rentals.
Right. So
you can rent a motorized boat and go out onto the lake, or you can do cruises. And especially at the Magic Kingdom, you can plan it during the fireworks show and you can go have a sunset cruise or an evening cruise and watch the fireworks while you're out in the water. So these hotels can be great for people that want to avoid the crowds and you'll still be able to see the fireworks show or get this great experience.
Speaking of crowds, I was just going to mention on that train of thought, you know, there's no worse feeling than coming back from a long day and then getting into a crammed room with whether it's two people, three kids, whatever. These rooms are huge. And when I mean huge, relatively speaking, we're talking, 400 square feet or so. And in the case of both places that me and my wife stayed at, Contemporary and Yacht Club, the first thing we mentioned when we walked in those rooms were, wow, these are large rooms. And so if you are just going by yourself, as a couple or with kids, you're going to have some space.
Yeah. And that's what's so great about the hotel rooms is that you're going to have like nicer beds, nicer linens. You're going to have a bigger bathroom, usually just better fixtures. That's what I like, especially when my husband is traveling with us and we have the kids. We don't like to feel like we're crammed in a room either. So most of these rooms will accommodate up to 5 people. And so that's really great.
Yeah. One of the other things that I think we can't discredit when it comes to the price is all the transportation options that you have.
Yes.
At Value Resorts, you know, unless it's the Pop Century Art of Animation Skyliner Station, you're really limited to bus travel. Now, which is fine. Bus travel, we appreciate. It's complimentary and it gets us around. When you get to moderate, you're starting to find more of the Skyliner. You're starting to find the bus still. But then when you get to the deluxe resorts, you've got a variety of options here. Anything from walking to Skyliner to monorail to water taxi. I mean, you know more than anybody about how you can get around, especially when you had your little foot thing going on.
Yes.
How important is it to have that variety of transportation at these deluxe resorts?
So I personally think that it's huge, and I think it's great for two kinds of travelers. So when you're thinking about families, something that I had to think about a lot, because there are a lot of times when I travel to Disney World by myself with the kids. So when they were at the age with strollers, I had to think about what were the transportation options, because when you ride a bus, you have to fold up your stroller to get on the bus. You do not have to fold up your stroller to get on the monorail or to get on a boat. So that was a huge factor if I'm traveling by myself, because if it's a long day, chances are one of the kids is going to fall asleep on the bus on the way back to the hotel. And then you have to figure out, what am I going to do with this kid and the stroller? It's also great. The convenience of these hotels is great if you're wanting to go back to the room in the middle of the day for a nap time or pool break. But then being able to walk to hotels is great for the older crowd. People that don't want to get on the bus be crammed into a bus pre-COVID times with a bunch of other people. It's nice to be able to just walk back at your leisure and get back quickly, or riding on the monorail. I know we have a debate, is the monorail transportation or is it a ride? It's always a ride for everybody.
Ride. Don't let that woman tell you differently. It's a ride.
And then also with my scooter as well, I have a new scooter. So getting onto the bus, I had to make sure that I had somebody with me to help get on the scooter. But for the monorail, I could just scoot on. For the Skyliner, I could just scoot on. Or I would just scoot over to Epcot. So it's definitely nice to have a variety of transportation options at the deluxe hotels.
I have two kind of final questions, and this is just going to be just for fun, just to get to know Mary Morning a little bit and all that. If I was to ask you which deluxe resort has your favorite theming. Which one would you say? I'll answer for it's only fair that I answer. Even though I'll ask another question later, but even though I've only stayed at Contemporary Yacht Club, I love Yacht Club for the simple reason of we are big Disney cruise people. And yeah. It just felt those rooms with the stately feel and calling it the nautical themes and all that. I mean, it made me miss a cruise ship, but it brought me right back. And I remember walking in the lobby that first time and there's Ale and Compass, one of the great restaurants that we ate at. And there is just, you know, there's the big globe in the middle. I mean, just it was almost like we were walking back onto the main lobby or the main atrium area of one of the Disney cruise ships. So that was my favorite theme one. You've stated more. What is your favorite theme deluxe resort?
My gosh, this is such a tough question. And I always tell everybody that you can't go wrong at any of the deluxe hotels because they're all so wonderful. But I guess as far as theming goes, I'd probably have to go with the Grand Floridian just because I love that luxurious feeling of, I don't know, you're on vacation, so you want to be treated like royalty.
There you go.
And I mean, what better way than to walk into the main lobby of the Grand Floridian? You usually have live music playing, you have the pianist playing Disney music, and you have the sense just kind of is this great welcoming feeling. So I would have to say that's my favorite theme. I mean, you can ask my husband, he has a different opinion, my kids have different opinions, my mom has different opinions, but
well, you know, and two we haven't touched on because they're not closed, but you talk about theming, Wilderness Lodge with its just incredible, just you're in nature. That there's no other way to describe it. You're in the huge lobby with the stone fireplace and the huge chairs. And that one
is especially popular during Christmas time.
Oh, yeah.
Because it just has that home for the holidays feeling. You have the big fireplace. You have the big Christmas tree in the middle. So that is one that books up very quickly during the holiday season.
The other one when you think about theming is Animal Kingdom Lodge.
Yeah.
I mean, if you think one of the rooms is a savanna room, you know, you look out the window and see the animals and it totally transports you basically into the Animal Kingdom without having to pay the price for a theme park.
Right. And I feel like Animal Kingdom Lodge doesn't get as much love or credit as it should because it doesn't have the location convenience as a lot of the other deluxe hotels.
Transportation.
It feels like it's a little further out there because it is next to Animal Kingdom and you have to take a bus to get everywhere. Mm-hmm. But it's really the bus ride isn't any longer than getting around from the other deluxe hotels. And yes, it has a beautiful lobby as well. You can choose a Savannah view room and people always question, yeah, it's a Savannah view, but are you really going to see the animals? Yes, you always see the animals. From the moment you wake up till the sun goes down, you can see the animals. It's not just they're awake, you know, 1 hour of the day. You'll see them all the time.
Well, that may be the next bucket list opportunity, but my final question comes back to what I thought was my ultimate bucket list. Me and you share a mutual love for the Contemporary Resort, and it may not have the most ornate building in the world. It may not have the best lobby in the world. But this past trip, I was convinced to do a split stay. We'll talk about split stays in a future article. But I was able to transfer in the middle of my vacation over to Contemporary just for one night. That's all I needed. Just one night so I could say I stayed there. And it was everything that I wanted it to be when I was growing up as a kid watching. When I was watching the Disney Channel and they would run commercials for Disney World and I'd see a monorail go through the hotel, if you will.
Yes.
I was like, that's the coolest thing ever. You mentioned the arcade. What else draws you to the Contemporary? Because there's so many options, but for whatever reason, for me and you, Contemporary just has always been the one. What is it for you about the Contemporary?
Yeah, and kind of going back to Animal Kingdom Lodge, like I feel like the Contemporary doesn't get as much love as it should just because it doesn't have this over-the-top theme like some of the others. So people think, oh, it doesn't appeal to me because it's not as attractive as, say, the Grand Floridian or the Polynesian. But I love the Contemporary for its convenience. Whenever I'm traveling, I love convenience. So first of all, you're right next to the Magic Kingdom. It's within walking distance, or you can ride the monorail. So who doesn't love riding the monorail? And I also love its size. So even though you have the main tower of the Contemporary, and then you have the Garden Wing and then Bay Lake Tower. So even though you have those separate buildings, they're still connected by a breezeway. So a lot of these other hotels, you have to leave the main lobby and go to a separate building. And that's not very appealing to me when I have to go to another building. So I love the size of the Contemporary, where everything is pretty much close together. And then it has some of the best food options, in my opinion. I love the Cliff Service, the Contempo Cafe. It has Chef Mickey's, which is a classic must-do, I feel like, for every family, because you get to see the Fab Five. It has The Wave, which is a little bit more of a casual restaurant. And then you have California Grill, which is an amazing experience because it's on the top floor and it has floor to ceiling windows and offers panoramic views of the Magic Kingdom area. So you can watch the fireworks from the restaurant when the fireworks are running, and they also pipe in the music for the fireworks into their restaurant. So it is definitely the ultimate experience to finish your day there.
Absolutely. And for me, you know, we stayed in the Garden Wing, which is on the opposite side of the park, kind of down that way. And we were on the third floor, which is the highest floor in the Garden Wing, probably at the last room down the hallway. So from our room to the front gate of Magic Kingdom, it took us 8.5 minutes to walk. Of course, the monorail was right outside our window. You know, when it says, oh, you're not going to have a theme park view. I didn't need the theme park view. I had the view of the monorail track with the monorail going by.
Which is just as exciting.
Well, I was a kid. I was literally a kid. And then, as you mentioned, just the dining options, the convenience of everything. I mean, Contemporary is not going to be the most flashy, but it never was. It never claimed to be that. It was just always the one that was the closest to the Magic Kingdom, the closest to the magic. And that's why it was always appealing for me growing up. So,
and it has huge rooms. That's something else that's appealing. So not all all the deluxe hotels have big rooms, but the Contemporary rooms are huge. And people, if you're staying in the main tower, they always ask, well, is it loud because of the monorail, or is it loud because of Chef Mickey's? And it's not. The monorail isn't loud at all. It just makes a low humming noise. And then with Chef Mickey's, those doors do not let much sound come through. So you are not going to hear anything there. So that's definitely not a concern, is noise.
You know, Walt Disney once said, it all started with a mouse. Believe it all started with Mary Morning. She's the one who kind of brought us together. I don't compare you to Walt Disney. I compare you to Jim Henson. You brought all these Muppets. Crazy entities together.
I'll take that.
You know, so here we are, and you can assign what Muppet to who, but you know, this is the lady who has brought us, who has made us believers. If you have had an experience with a Believe Vacations agent, and if you have had a wonderful, hopefully, experience under the Believe Vacations name, this is the lady to thank for you. So again, her contact information is running. Even if you just want to thank her for what she believed in and getting us going, I know we try to do that daily. But, you know, when you think of Believe Vacations, Mary Morning, we'll close with this. What separates us? What makes us stand out? Why are we different? And there's agents all over the place. They show up. They call themselves whatever they want to call themselves.
Yeah.
Why Believe? And that's how I will let you take from here.
Yeah, so something that I always preach, something that sets us apart from other agencies, is our team. It's our people. So we're not just a company, we're like a family. We all help and support each other and encourage each other. We have the best time together on vacation. So we just came back from our team trip. We're already ready to plan our next team trip. So that is what sets us apart. We all believe in the magic. We all enjoy giving each other a hard time and just discussing Disney on a daily basis. So we're just a little family. We're here to have fun. Don't take things too seriously, but we're also experienced. We only bring on experienced agents that know the parks and can help our clients from those personal experiences.
Absolutely. Heard it from the boss herself. Well, thank you guys for watching. This is going to conclude our series on the different levels of resorts. We hope you enjoyed it. We hope you found it informative. Again, my thanks to Kyle, who helped us with value resorts. My thanks to Amanda, who helped us with moderates. And of course, the big boss lady, who helped us with the lux. So thank you, Merry Morning, for all you do, for joining me today. And until next time, be a believer, and we'll see you real soon.
Bye.
Don't stop.